very much, everybody. Oh gosh, it's lovely to be back at Watermelon Wednesdays. It's such a treat, and I'm here with Nick, one of my very, very favorite artists, and this is one of my favorite collaborations. It's really a treat to bring Nick to you guys. Isn't he fantastic? And we've got more friends, and it kind of feels like I'm among friends. I know I'm among friends. There's many harping friends in the audience, so thanks for giving us such a warm welcome back here. Believe it or not, how does this sound? There's a lot of microphones around, but essentially it's acoustic.
Yes.
Okay. I wasn't really trying. Okay, awesome. That was a set called Waves. It was a tune by Scottish fiddler Aidan O'Rourke called The Waves of Rush into a tune I wrote called Chisaw. Last summer, it was a fiddler, Duncan Wickle, and I did a little tour on the West Coast, and we went right up to northeastern Washington State. And I'd never been there, and I'd never even thought about what it would be like. And I was blown away by the epic scale of the landscape, the rolling hills, the massive skies. And we were just shown a great time. They bought us this tiny little town called Chisaw. They bought us to a rodeo, and they bought us Western horseback riding. I grew up riding English style a little bit, so it was a treat to try Western horseback riding. And they taught me how to two-step, and it was great. So I wrote this tune called Chisaw in dedication to that lovely place. The next tune I wrote for Nick over here, you'll hear this kind of gritting and grating, and it's because he's dancing on sand. So before every gig, Nick needs to locate a beach, or he has to get hold of sand somehow. And so I call him the sand hunter, and I like to think of him creeping up on an unsuspecting little piece of sand and pouncing. And I feel sorry for those poor little sand pieces that get so crushed by his feet. But I wrote him this tune called The Sand Hunter. Speak more in the bike.
Yes. I want to hear your voice.
Thanks. Paul. Better? Louder?
Better.
Could we turn off the mic?
Yes, we can.
Cool.
It's because she's not from here.
One, two, one, two, one, two. There we go.
It's a little better.
So this is a tune called The Sand Hunter. Thank you. realize that Nick doesn't have a mic to talk into. Nick, you've got anything worthwhile to say for the
video? Open your hymnals to number 10.
I'll sing a song. This is a kind of a moving on, brushing off the dust kind of song. It's called City in the North.
Sentimental memory.
collaboration with Nick has been a chance, kind of, I think, for us both to explore various soundscapes and colors that our instruments can produce. I think Nick can explain it better than I can, how often people think of as a harp and dance as playing completely different roles. How would you?
Yeah. Maybe sometimes they get shoved to opposite ends of the aesthetic spectrum. The harp maybe has a very particular association. Maybe dancing.
Airy fairy, wispy, wispy.
And dancing has another very particular association, whether it's dancing from this country or dancing from Ireland or from the American South or from Spain. And I think one of the things that Maeve and I are really interested in doing is trying to get the harp to dance and then trying to make the dance sing a little bit. And we're sort of going to try that in this next piece. This is a tune called Peary, which I learned as an American, it means little. Peary Joel.
It's by Ali Moller, a great Swedish multi-instrumentalist. And then we'll go into an Irish tune. Tommy Peoples. It's Tommy Peoples' tune, great Irish fiddle player. Into a couple of pipe reels. Molten the Optics, written by Hamish Moore, who's a great Scottish pipe player. His son, Finn Moore, is also a great, they're both great pipe makers as well as players. Into a tune that the Irish say is Irish and the Scottish say is Scottish, and it's most definitely Scottish. It's called
in your lap. graduated from college, my parents were really excited about my choice of graduate school discipline. They were delighted because I chose to study something called ethnochoreology, which to them sounded like ethnocolonoscopy. And it sounded to them like I was going into medicine. And so they were like super happy. But it wasn't about that. It's ethnochoreology is the discipline of looking at dance in its cultural context. And like ethnomusicology, it draws from a lot of different world movement traditions and looks at the ways that it fits into people's cultures and the way they make meaning their life around it. So part of that project for me was to imagine what it would be like for cultures that didn't necessarily have a percussive dancing style of their own. Unlike here in the United States, where we have American clogging or tap dancing, or in Canada, where they have step dancing from Quebec or Cape Breton. I thought, what would it be like if there was step dancing in Norway? And so it sort of began this long thought experiment of like, what would it look like? What would people have to do to get their feet around the tunes and the special types of rhythms that occur in the Nordic countries? And so this is sort of an extension of that experiment. It's called Nordfring Halling, and Halling is a traditional dance that's done typically by men, and the climax of the piece is an acrobatic kick of a hat off of a broom that's held like by somebody.
I've never seen Nick do this. I'm really looking forward to it tonight.
So we didn't bring the hat or the broom or the brave soul who's going to hold it. So we'll try and interpret this tune. Pulling from different dance styles from different places.
We got a broom in the back room.
Right. And we'll start right now.
Quick!
Hurry!
Can you get your hats?
Thank you.
couldn't believe it when a car pulled up before the concert, and one of my biggest mentors and one of the most brilliant fiddle players I know pulled up. Mr. Daryl Anger here is here in the audience just to hang. Isn't that awesome? Me and Nick kind of met while playing in Daryl's band. We bonded in Daryl's band, and so he's a lot of the reason that we're playing music right now. And I'd love to invite Daryl Anger up to the stage to play a song with me. Is my favorite road because it brings me from where I live to here. And every summer I teach this great harp camp which starts tomorrow at Angel's Rest, and there's a lot of harp players here tonight. And I just kind of shed my troubles when I start on this journey. And I was looking out at the golden sunlight that was all around, and it was just so beautiful. And made me want to sing epic American song, and there's none more epic than the one I'm going to try and sing. It was taught to me by a great mandolin player called Tom Rosen at a music camp in Shasta, California, just a few weeks ago, I guess. And it's just full of the most gorgeous imagery of America. It's really glorious, and I'll try and remember the words now so you can get a sense of it. Then maybe we'll play another tune afterwards.
Close enough for classical.
Thank you.
Thank you.
she sings.
This was nerve-wracking part of the show for me.
Great.
Well, listen, folks, it's time that you see some bats and eat some watermelon. And we're going to play one more set for you. Thank you for being here. This is very special for us. And Joran Tice and Maeve Gilchrist and Nic again are just going to get you up and dancing in the second half. Thanks again for being here. There's CDs, I have CDs, Nic has CDs. We've got an emailing list. We're starting an emailing list as a new project, so if you'd like to know what we're doing, that's there. Thank you very much to Paul for being here and to you all. Enjoy your evening. Mr. Nic Gareiss.
Thank you. Thanks, guys. Let's see here. We started things in Sweden for y'all with a polska like Mia mentioned. And then we brought it right actually to your backyard with a kind of, I guess, a contra dance tune,
yeah.
Kind of a march that might be written by somebody that somebody here knows or something like that. And we don't know who wrote it, but it's from this, you know, it's from out here. It's definitely played a lot of.
Thomas Bartlett.
Thomas Bartlett.
Bartlett.
Thomas Bartlett wrote the song. And now we are going to do an arrangement of two tunes from Sweden that Nick and I bonded over a love of a guitar player and tune writer named Ian Carr, who he's kind of just in a league of his own. You should just check him out. And he basically deconstructs and messes with everything and just totally in your face about it. And he just comes up with some of the coolest stuff. And we're going to play, kind of borrow an arrangement from him of a tune, just a very traditional polska from Nas, and then a tune that he wrote called Bigger House. Thank you. moving forward, we're going to play a tune of mine that I wrote called A Cool Dog. No story, no nothing. That's all. No great concept, no ambitions. We're not teaching anybody anything with this tune. Challenging nothing.
This is for enough. Bear. For the dog.
Yeah, it's or not even that specific.
Oh.
For nothing in particular. This tune's called A Cool Dog. Everybody hear everything okay? Everything coming across? Sweet.
Uh-oh. Oh, yeah.
Uh-oh.
Nice.
Mm.
okay?
Oh, gosh.
Can we hang your bag of sand on the other end?
Really?
I told you I would never leave you, wrap my arms and wings around you. How many times would love find us wanting? How many times would love find us free? If we ran into the woods together, ran until we found shelter, how many times would love find us falling? How many times would love find us?
That I wrote that doesn't really have a name yet, but I wrote it 2 weeks ago and thought that it would really, thought it would be such a treat to play it with me and Nick. So we learned it yesterday, and here it is. Thank you. Everybody. Everybody thanks somebody right now. All right, we're going to play another Ian cartoon for you right now. And that's it. Thank you. decided to do a little solo number for you guys.
I'm just going to take this.
Let's see here. I tried to do a blues song, an old blues song called Wild Bill James. It's kind of maybe more known these days in the old-time bluegrass communities, which have appropriated it. So, kind of messing around with it lately. I'm going to inappropriate it.
As I went out for to take a little walk, I came upon that Wild Bill Jones. He was walking and talking by my true lover's side, and I bid him to leave her alone. He said, my age, it is 21 years too old. So I pulled my revolver from my side, and I destroyed that poor boy's soul. Saying, honey, won't you take me home? So pass around that old long neck bottle, and we'll all go on a spree. But for today was the last of that Wild Bill Jones, and tomorrow's gonna be the last of me. They sent me to prison for 20 long years. This poor boy longs to be free. But Wild Bill Jones in that long neck bottle has been the ruin of me.
think it might be time.
Who would like to see Maeve Gilchrist play some more?
The fiddler that usually plays with Jordan in the setting couldn't make it, and Mia just stepped in there, and I'm just standing at the back, amazed at the ease with which she's playing with these tunes.
Yeah.
So, yeah. You guys might remember, was anyone here when I was here with Tashina Claridge and Jefferson Hamer?
Yes. Yes.
Okay. We played this. The song called Churchyard. Wait, you should tell them about the song. I just think it's funny that I'm here with another tall, dark, handsome guitar player playing the same song.
Anyways, yeah, our good friend Jefferson, I heard him singing this song at a session in New York City. And I was like, man, like that song rules. And I know like 10 songs, and that is going to be the 11th. And anyway, so I found out it was from Martin Carthy, who is just a great collector of songs, singer and guitar player and performer. And he did the song, so I kind of inappropriated it again. So, and Maeve is going to help me out, because we are both huge fans of this. Thank you.
that dark, lonely tomb where a savior has lain and conquered gloom. I press in the hope that one bright day sunshine will burst through these prisons of clay, and old Gabriel's trumpet and the voice of the Lord will wake up the dead in the old churchyard. I rest in the hope that one bright day sunshine will burst through these prisons of clay, and old Gabriel's trumpet and the voice of the Lord will wake up the dead.
Watermelon was shared.
We'd all like to thank Paul for bringing us here and being so many great. Nic Gareiss, Maeve Friedman, Joran Tice, I'm Maeve Gilchrist. We're going to take one more chance.
Thank you.
something like kind of nice and like chill.
Turbo try on?
How about red for John?
Sorry, we've not got this.
Yeah.
Let's
yeah.
Yeah, like not like ultra chill, okay. But like medium
not
chill.
This is a. I feel like old time music is kind of my happy comfort point coming from Scotland to America. I can't quite make it to bluegrass, so I love to listen to it. But like old time kind of makes sense for me to join in. This is a tune called Red Prairie Dawn.
Thank you.